So let's take up the discussion on the problems of wireless LAN protocols. So as I mentioned in my earlier video that we cannot use the collision detection aspect, but however we can have carrier sensing. But because of carrier sensing, we may encounter two new kinds of problems called hidden terminal problem and exposed terminal problem. So what is that hidden terminal and exposed terminal? Let us understand through various slides. It's very interesting. Please follow. So kindly do remember that each radio of a host, wireless host, transmitter has a limited fixed range. Range is represented by a circular circle like this. So this is the range of host A, this is the range of host C, this is the range of host A and the range of host C like this. That means within this radio range of host A, this is a host A, machine A, access point, or you may say station A, whatever. So within this, whoever is present, they can be able to see the transmissions of A. Within this C, this is the radio range of C. So whoever are present within the radio range of station C, they can be able to see the signals transmitted by C or simultaneously received. So do remember that within the radio range of A, I have stations A and B, but C is not present. Within the radio range of C, so let me tell you that this is the radio range of C, this is the radio range of A. So within the radio range of C, I have station B and D, but A is not present within C, means A cannot send the data to C cannot receive the data from A and vice versa. So similarly here. So because of this, what problems are we going to have? We have two most common problems called hidden node and exposed node. So what is hidden node problem? Let us first understand from this, and then I will show you in detail a later point of time. The stations A and C are said to be hidden with respect to B. With respect to B, A and C are hidden, meaning now whenever A wants, it can sense whether B is transmitting or not. C also can sense whether B is transmitting or not. But A cannot sense for C and C cannot sense for A. So imagine, for example, at some point of time, A and C together tries to sense whether B is idle or B is busy in transmission. So both of them will find B to be idle because A cannot sense C and C cannot sense A. So simultaneously they may transmit the data to B and the data will get garbled at station B. And that will lead to an unsuccessful transmission. Why is this happening? This is happening because A cannot sense the traffic, or A cannot sense the signals of C and C cannot sense the signals of A. So therefore we say A and C are hidden to each other. Because of this it is leading to collision. So that's one problem. Second problem that may happen here are the exposed terminals. Who are exposed? B and C are exposed terminals when transmitting to A and D, like kindly observe. So B and C are within the communication range of each other. Kindly observe, B and C are within the communication range of each other. But A and C are not, like that D and B are not. D and B are not within the communication range of each other. I hope you're not. Or you take this station A. A is not within the communication range of C and also D. And like that, C and D are not in the communication range of A. But of course, B and C are within the communication range of each other. So they can sense. So what happens is at some point of time, imagine B wants to transmit to A and C wants to transmit to D. B wants to transmit to A and C wants to transmit to D. So what happens before transmitting? They will sense. So they will sense each other. So C will sense B and see that, okay, B is sending some signals. B will also sense C and see that, okay, C is also sending some signals. So unfortunately, what happens? They will keep silent. They will become silent. But unknowingly, I mean, they don't know that B wants to transmit A and C wants to transmit D, and they can transmit without any problem because A and D are not in communication with each other. So when B is transmitting to A and C is transmitting to D, that communication will not get interfered and will not happen. But unfortunately, what happens? Sensing each other, they remain silent because they are exposed to that signal. They are exposed to that signal and remain silent. But actually, they should not have been silent. They should have continued with their transmission, but that is not happening. That is called exposed terminal problems. Okay. So wireless networks in general will have two kinds of problems, hidden terminal and exposed terminal. So look at that. With more clarity, we are explaining here. So A and C are not in communication range of each other. A and B are in communication range of each other, and C and B are also. So both A and C, which are out of range of each other, tries to sense for B. B is idle. So simultaneously, they transmit, that will result in collision. at the intended receiver. Receiver is B, is a receiver, is sender, sender. So this is called hidden. So A and C are hidden terminals. Another diagram I try to show here, same thing. Station A, read the statement. Hidden terminal problem is a transmission problem that arises when two or more stations who are out of range of each other. Look at this. Within this range of station A, B is present. Within this range of station C, B is present. But A and C are out of range of each other. Transmit simultaneously to a common recipient. This is prevalent in decentralized systems where there are not much entities for controlling transmissions. So this occurs when a station is visible from a wireless access point, but is hidden from other stations. That is, this is visible to this. This is visible to this, but these two are hidden to each other. Suppose now that there are three stations labeled STA, STB. Look at this diagram. So STA and STC, STA and STC are transmitting while STB is receiving. The stations are in configuration such that the two transmitters STA and are not in the radio range of each other. As shown, it will result in collision. So when they simultaneously send the data, it will lead to collision. That is hidden terminal problem. Now exposed terminals, who can sense each other but still transmit safely to a different receivers. So different receivers, receiver 1, receiver 2. But unfortunately, that does not happen because when they simultaneously, both B and C are in the radio range of each other, simultaneously sense each other and keep silent, whereas they should not have kept silent, they can continue the transmission. So therefore, here in earlier case, collision is happening, and here the transmission is getting stopped unnecessarily because of exposed terminals. So B and C are exposed to each other and abort their transmissions, which otherwise would have continued. That is exposed terminal problem. So both of them are not. I mean, again, by means of another diagram, I'm trying to show exposed. So this is another way of representing the radio range of station A. This is orange color. So this is the radio range of station A. The blue color, this is radio range of station B. Green color, radio range of station C. Violet color, radio range of station D. So B and A are in the radio range. C and D are in the radio range. And B and C are in the radio range. You can check this. This is overlapping with this. So therefore, they are in the radio range of each other. But A and D are not in the range of each other. A and D are not in the range of each other. So if this fellow want to send to this fellow want to send, that's what is happening. Presently transmitting, it cannot transmit. Why? Because it senses that B is in use. Because it is in the communication range. So it maintains silence. Otherwise, this would have continued. This should have continued it. So that is leading to wastage of bandwidth. So that should not happen. So read the statement. There are four stations labeled A, B, C, D. STB and STC are transmitters. STB and STC are transmitters. And STD and STA are receivers. Okay. STA and STD are receivers. The stations are in configuration such that the two receivers, STA, A and D, are out of range of each other. But the two transmitters are in the radio range of each other. Right. They expose and keep silent. So that is exposed terminal problem. So these two problems should not happen. Then how are we going to solve this problem? This particular problem, let me talk, go to the page. So the problems of hidden terminal and exposed terminal is solved by upgrading CSMA protocol with collision avoidance. Okay, CSMA CA, collision avoidance. How is this collision avoided? Collision avoidance. And this revised protocol, upgraded protocol, in the literature is known as MACA, which stands for multiple access with collision avoidance. Now this MACA protocol, MACA protocol, was proposed by a person called Kahn, K-A-R-N, Kahn, in the year 1990, it was proposed by Kahn. This is based on a handshaking method called RTS-STS, RTS-CTS. What do RTS stands for? RTS stands for request to send. And CTS stands for clear to send. What is the idea behind this CTS? These are what, now what? Both RTS and CTS are, they are small packets or small frames, maybe of size 30 bytes, that contain information about who is the sender, who is the receiver, and then what is the duration of transfer, size of transfer. All that information will be put in this RTS. Means the basic objective is for hidden terminal problem, collision may happen, that should be avoided. For exposed terminal problem, it appears like collision is going to happen, but the communication should continue. So that can be done by using this RTS and CTS. So the protocol, I'm going to describe the protocol in the slide later point of time. Just understand in the beginning, any station, wireless station, who is desiring to send some data to another station should first send an RTS, request to send, assuming that the receiver is within the communication range of it, request to send. Now, when this request to send arrives at the intended receiver, and if the receiver is in a mood to receive it, it will send clear to send. It is just like taking permission from the receiver. The receiver agrees for the permission, then the communication goes on between them. Then all the other hosts, all the other clients, all the other radio stations which are present within the radio range of the person who has sent RTS must remain silent. And all those who are listening the CTS may continue to avoid the exposed terminal problem, may continue transmitting the data to other than the intended sender. I'll describe it, how does it work. So let's go to the slide to continue this. What is the solution to hidden and exposed terminal? Look at this. It's solved by medium access layer protocol by using RTS, and the standard of that is called, here, let me play it and use the ink plus a follow. So the protocol is now given an IEEE standard called 802.11 RTS and CTS. I told you what is RTS and CTS, with the condition that the stations must be synchronized with each other and frame sizes and data speed are the same. Otherwise, it will lead to mismatches. So RTS stands for request to send and CTS stands for clear to send. Look at this paradigm. A transmitting station sends an RTS frame to the receiving station. The receiving station replies by sending a CTS frame. On receipt of CTS, the transmitting station begins the transmission. Any station, other station, hearing the RTS and is close to the transmitting station, means within the radio range of it, should remain silent, naturally, to avoid collision. Long enough for the CTS to arrive and complete the data transmission. Any station just hearing the CTS, not RTS, just hearing the CTS and is close to the receiving station should remain silent during the data transmission. To the same host, it cannot, right? To other host, it can. In the above example, like for the first example, the station STC, so let me go to that, hidden terminal problem. In this example, the station STC, so that's what, read the comment. The station STC does not hear RTS. Look at this again, I'm going back. The station STC does not, because if STS and RTS, so RTS will come to STB, but cannot be heard by STC because this is not within the range. The signal which is issued by station A cannot be heard by station C. So station B can hear RTS. So if I issue RTS, it can be received by STS, station B, but it cannot be heard by station C. That's what the point is. So in the above example, station C does not hear RTS from station A, but hears CTS. It hears CTS from station B, because when station B responds with STS, CTS, then that can be heard by STC. So in that case, STC should remain silent for communication with STB, assuming that station B is going to receive some data now from a station which is closer in radio range to station B. So it should remain silent. So when it remains silent, then obviously collision will not happen. So that's how the problem can be solved. So, but here's a CTS from station B. So it understands that STB is busy. So defer its transmission, and therefore we can avoid collision. So that is the problem which can be solved, right? So same thing again can be explained by means of another example. This is from your textbook of Tenenbaum. I have taken solution to hidden node and exposed node problem using MACA protocol, right? Using RTS. So what happens here? Look at this. A and B are within the radio range. D is not. C is within the radio range of A. E is within the radio range of both A and B. E is within the radio range of A and B. So this is the range of transmitter A, this is the range of transmitter B. So how do a MACA protocol work? Sender sends RTS frame to inform all stations. So when sender A sends RTS, it will be heard by E and it will be heard by C. But since the destination station name is named in RTS, so therefore B only supposed to respond to that. C and E should remain silent. C and E should remain silent and therefore it can avoid collision. Now B will respond CTS. Look at that in the second. Receiver uses CTS clear to send frame to inform all stations before replying to senders. So whoever is there in the radio range of, now who is there in the radio range of B? A is there, E is there, D is there. So what happens here? Kindly observe. What I wanted to show you, RTS will be heard by C. RTS will be heard by E, will be heard also by B. But RTS will not be heard by D. Now when B is say that, okay, I'm ready to receive your transmission, B will respond CTS. So now this CTS will be heard by A, will be heard by E, will not be heard by C. So C is only hearing RTS, please observe. And CTS will also be heard by D. CTS will also be heard by D, all right? So CTS will be heard by this. So what is the receiver uses CTS frame to inform all stations before replying to senders. To all stations, it informs through CTS, okay? So now D is going to remain silent, E is going to remain silent, and therefore the only communication takes place between A and B, between A and B. So that is the paradigm. So some stations will hear both RTS and CTS. So to the same intender, they will not transmit. Like C will not transmit to A. E will not transmit to A and also B because it heard both. So here C will not transmit to A. Huh, for example, there is another station F somewhere here and it is within the radio range of station C, for example. So while this transmission is going on, this transmission can also go on. So it will avoid exposed terminal problem. Suppose within D there is another host H. So B and D are within the communication range of each other. How the exposed terminal problem is solved? D will observe, okay, it has heard CTS. That means B is in a receiving mode. But it understands that H, it has not anything heard from, it has not heard anything from H. H is totally out of range from B. So this communication, if possible, can go on. Exposed terminal problem. So using this RTS and CTS simple mechanism, we can overcome the hidden and exposed terminal problem. So this is a simple flowchart to illustrate the working of IEEE 802.1 RTS CTS exchange. So start, assemble a frame at the host. Then we first sense the channel in the radio range. If it is the channel ideal? No, wait for back of time. Channel is in use, wait for back of time and again keep on sensing. Carrier sensing is going on. Otherwise, the channel is ideal. For example, if the channel is ideal, then there are two things. I can work without RTS STS or I can work with STS. So this is working, this is the working of the protocol with RTS and CTS. This is the working of the protocol without RTS and CTS. So if I'm not using RTS, CTS handshaking, then directly I will transmit the application data and end. Otherwise, if I use RTS and CTS paradigm, then the sender transmitter will transmit the RTS request to send. CTS received or not? No, it is not received. Again, wait for back of time because there might have been instant simultaneous collision. So therefore, again, repeat the process. Otherwise, if you receive CTS, then transmit the application data, as simple as that. So this is the paradigm of wireless protocol called MAC-A with RTS and CTS handshaking. So this could be a simple 5-mark question in your JNTU exam asking about wireless LAN or maybe asking about the problems of hidden terminal and exposed terminals in wireless LAN and how the hidden and exposed terminal problems are solvable by using MAC-A protocol, multiple access collision avoidance protocol proposed by Khan using the handshaking mechanism of RTS and CTS. Okay.